Hope everyone is doing great. So I am Manivannan, and this is my colleague Shomashekar. We are from eBay, and in eBay we are part of DevEx team. DevEx expands for developer experience. We take pride in creating tools and environments for eBay. Basically, eBay developers are our customers. And what we are, the story we are going to share today is like how we actually started utilizing the resources more effectively for the Jenkins and continuous integration, basically. And is it better now?
A little bit.
Better now?
Yeah.
Okay. So at eBay Inc., we take continuous integration very seriously. You know, the every line of code that we write that goes to through continuous integration before it goes to live. And for continuous integration, we predominantly use Jenkins. We have been using Jenkins for years now, and we have been associated with Koshuke and other folks in CloudBees for years now, and we have also contributed back to Jenkins core itself and also for some of the plugins, to name a few, Jenkins Mesos plugin, Shell Project plugin, yeah, a couple of other plugins as well. And before we get into what we have implemented, the solution we implemented, I just want to give a background on how we used to do continuous integration in both PayPal and as well as eBay. In PayPal, we run one Jenkins server for the whole company. So we call it Fusion. And what developers do is they just create their jobs on Fusion, and they run nightly builds or a policium, whatever it is, and also the deploy also goes through Fusion. So, and we have around 100 nodes that are configured in that Jenkins server, which actually takes care of all the builds. We run about 12,000 builds every day. So the advantage we had here was resource utilization was fairly good, because the slaves are used only when there is a demand. But the problem is, it is one server for the whole company. When something goes wrong, if we have to restart Fusion, the all the jobs are lost. I mean, running jobs are lost. So that is the disadvantage. And the advantage is like the resource utilization is fair. And so all the unit test, automation test, everything goes through Fusion only, Jenkins. And this is about PayPal. And eBay world, it is totally different. So when I am a developer and I onboard to eBay today, so I'll just request for my application as well as CI system, everything. So what we do is we basically create a VM and install Jenkins on top of it and give it to the developer. So this was very good, because a developer would get their own instance of Jenkins. They can install plugins. They can upgrade to a newer version of Jenkins. Basically, they can do the freedom to do everything they want. But the problem is, I'll tell about the pros and cons. Like the in the VM, there will be two executors to run all the builds. So there is no node concept. It is just the master having two executors to do the builds. And the pros is like the users were happy, because they can install whatever they want. They can put their own plugin, or they can install whatever the plugin they want, and they can upgrade to newer version of Jenkins. So on the DevOps side, the issues were isolated only to that particular instance. If you think about Fusion, where we run all the jobs for entire PayPal, one server, when something goes wrong, I mean, all the jobs are lost. But in this case, it is only one, it is isolated only to that instance. So we had that advantage, but the cons are like, we started giving out VMs to developers. Like one point of time, there were around 2,500 VMs given out for the developers. And when we look at the statistics, only 10% of those VMs were actually used. Out of those 10%, only 5 to 10 minutes per day it was used. They run hardly one or two builds per day. So all those resources are wasted. Basically, we spend millions of dollars just to maintain those resources. So instead of having individual VMs, so what we planned was to come up with a plan to move all the VMs to a cloud and just create CI create slaves out of the cluster only when there is a demand. And luckily, Jenkins helps us with the cloud API with which Jenkins Mesos plugin works, which I'll cover in the next couple of slides. So we actually did a lot of analysis on the available tools on market to build the cluster itself. And we found that Apache Mesos and Jenkins goes well with this. So before we get into the solution, there are some challenges which we had to overcome with the new solution that we are going to propose. So one thing is developers were happy because they have their own individual Jenkins, but we have to put a smile on DevOps too. So because the resources were wasted, basically DevOps, we were unhappy. And we wanted to preserve the user experience. We wanted to give the we don't want to disturb the user experience. The users should still feel that he has his own dedicated Jenkins. But other things we should handle, whatever the cluster or whatever, we should handle ourselves in our CI system. But for the user, it should be a seamless experience. And of course, high availability. And self-healing infrastructure. So self-healing in the sense to an extent. So when something goes wrong, when a Jenkins instance is provisioned, and when it comes back, reprovisioned again, it should heal itself and the instance should come back. So that was our goal. And this is the basic overview of, there are two parts in it. One is giving away the Jenkins master itself, and the other part is the build, where we are going to execute the build. So the Jenkins master for everyone, so we thought we'd give a lightweight Jenkins to everyone. Since the slaves, we can spawn on demand from the cluster. So it is enough if we give just 0.4 CPU and 512 megabytes of RAM. So that is sufficient to run Jenkins itself. And for the user, it would just be Jenkins. So he won't know that executor is going to be spawned from the cluster. So is everyone aware of Mesos, cluster manager software? How many of you? Okay, so maybe I can just skim through, just give a little background about what Mesos is. So Apache Mesos is a cluster management software, which is open source, and it is very good. That is the software which we use to build the cluster out of the VMs. And the architecture is classic, like basic master and slave mode. It basically has a Mesos master and a bunch of slaves. So when you run master daemon on a VM, it is going to behave as a master. And slave daemon, one per VM, it will behave as a slave and it will connect to master. In Mesos terms, when the slave advertises itself to master, it is termed as offer. So when a slave comes up in the cluster, it will tell that, hey, I have some 5 CPUs and some 2 gigs of RAM. If you want to use it, go ahead and use it. So the offers are from master, it is sent to a framework. So Marathon and Jenkins are framework. Framework in the sense, it will internally implement schedulers in them. So when a framework registers to Mesos master, it will start receiving offers from the slaves. So, and for high availability, we have a couple of more masters. So this is active passive model where we have one leading master all the time. Other Mesos masters will be standby. When one goes down, other comes up and says, hey, I'll lead this. So that guy becomes the leader from then on. For leader election, we use Zookeeper. So Zookeeper actually manages who is the leader in the Mesos cluster, who is the leading master right now. And slaves also use Zookeeper to do the leader discovery to connect. So this is just an overview of Mesos. So in Mesos, any thing, say you want to run a command, say sleep 100. So you need a piece of slave or piece of executor to execute that command. So from your scheduler, you'll request for that piece of slave, and your slave will give that offer. When the offer matches, you'll pick that offer and run your command. And the smallest unit of work in Mesos is called as task. And that is on the Jenkins master part. And if we have, we don't have to give executors on the master. So what we planned was give the slave the machine to run the builds in Jenkins. That is also on the demand. When a user creates a job and he clicks on build now, the slave should be spawned out of the cluster. So, and the build should be done. After the build is done, it should be given back to the cluster. So for that, Jenkins Mesos plugin was very handy for us. And the community, Jenkins Mesos plugin community, that is very active. And Vinod in community was helping us very much. And we have also contributed a lot of fixes to this plugin. Right now it is matured and we are using it, Mesos plugin to manage the slave part. I'll just tell about the contributions that we have made towards the end. So this is the complete architecture of the solution that we have implemented. So the top one, CIAS, that is CI as a service. We have application running. This is implemented on Node.js. This is going to take requests for CI. Whenever a user comes and requests for CI, the request is routed to CIAS, and from CIAS it is to Marathon. So Marathon is a scheduler for Mesos. We would use Marathon when we have long-running tasks. So for us, Jenkins master itself is a long-running task that is going to be there forever for the user. So when, say, you spawn a Jenkins master using Marathon, and if it goes down or if it shuts down for some reason, Marathon knows that and it'll spawn another one for you. Basically, it manages the long-running applications. And from Marathon, the request goes to Mesos master. As I told in the other slide, Zookeeper is for leader discovery. This guy is going to keep track of who is the leading Mesos master now. And from Mesos master, the request, basically, the request goes to Mesos slaves, and the slave will be able to spawn you a Jenkins master. So the diagram I have here is for Jenkins master, and assume that these are Jenkins slaves. So both are out of the same cluster, but instead of one VM serving as one Jenkins, we actually sliced it down so that one VM can spawn some 20 Jenkins masters. And we use NFS storage instead of local storage. So the master, basically the Jenkins home for each Jenkins instance that is created, that is going to reside in NFS mode. So that if something goes wrong, when the CI itself goes down and it gets respawned again, the user doesn't have to worry about the plugins he upgraded or the jobs he created. It is going to be from the NFS mode. The directory will be available, and Jenkins will be able to come up with all the stuff he installed. And for slave also, we use mount to have the workspace. This is for reduced build time. When we have the workspace, say we have a config, we use Git for SCMH. So when we have Git, you have a job where you check out your code from Git and run the build. So when the code is already available in the workspace, it is just going to do a Git fetch. If it is not available, then it is going to clone the whole code. So since the workspace resides on NFS mode, even if the slave dies and if the build is triggered again, the workspace will be available. So the time taken for Git to your executor, that will be much less. It will do only a fetch. So this is the architecture. And about the contributions that we did for Mesos plugin, when we started with Jenkins Mesos plugin, we had a need to have a custom workspace. By default, at that time, Jenkins Mesos plugin was creating the workspace inside the Mesos work directory, which is temp/Mesos. But we wanted a custom workspace, like I told in the previous slide, we had a NFS mount. We wanted to use that NFS mount as a workspace for the slaves. So this enhancement, we did it in the Jenkins Mesos plugin, and we also contributed it back. And another thing was like the Mesos plugin initially, it was allowing only one flavor of slave that can be spawned. For example, I can only say I need a slave with 2 CPU and 4 gigs of RAM with this attribute or whatever. But we in eBay, we had a need for different types of slaves for different type of jobs. Say I have a lightweight job which just does only a Java build. I need only 2 CPUs there. And I have a large code base where it's a heavy job. It's going to need more executor to run the build. So for that, I would need a heavy node. So basically, I would need an array of slaves. I should be able to have different flavors of slaves based on the job type, so that I can label the job to say, this job is heavy, it will pick a heavy slave and it will run the build. So if I say label the job as lightweight, it will go to a lightweight node and do the build. And another thing is the workspace. You'll be able to view the workspace only if the slave is online. But with the Jenkins Mesos plugin, the slave will be given back to the cluster once your build is complete and after the idle timeout. So your slave won't be available online in Jenkins. So in that case, you wouldn't be able to view workspace. But our customers, developers, they wanted to view the workspace for downloading coverage, code coverage report, or view the artifacts or whatever. So for that, we have enhanced the Mesos plugin to be able to access the workspace, because the workspace itself is available in NFS mode. All that we need to do from Mesos plugin is to enable it so that we can view the workspace even if the slave is not there. So that enhancement also we have did and contributed back to Mesos plugin. And initially Maven jobs were not able to run, we were not able to run Maven jobs with the Mesos plugin. That was because of a class path issue. And we have fixed that as well and contributed back to Mesos plugin. And another fix was to disconnect slaves after idle timeout. So there are different states for a slave when it is provisioned to Mesos cluster. So a couple of them are terminal states where when you should actually forget the slave is not available anymore and you should disconnect from the cluster basically. So that we faced an issue when we were crossing 800 apps, 800 CAs basically, and we fixed that issue and contributed back to Mesos plugin. And having said that, I'll hand over to Soma, who will show the demo of the CA application that we have implemented.
Thanks, Manny. Thanks. Hi, guys. So as Mani mentioned, we are using Marathon for scheduling and Mesos cluster for our Jenkins master as well as Jenkins slaves. So as part of this demo, I will show what is Marathon, what is Mesos, and how we are using these tools, and what we have developed, how users are going to create their CIs, and how slaves are getting spawned. So when we have seen the flow, we have seen Marathon, Mesos, and the CI as a service, and the request flows through CI as a service, and which in turn uses Marathon for scheduling. So we have a orchestration engine which acts as a user interface, which enables the users to create CI instances. We CI as a service, the application provides a REST interface for that particular application. As we are doing a demo, I won't be showing the application orchestration engine, but I would use the REST interface using the REST client to simulate the creation of the CI instance or the Jenkins instance. So this is the REST URL which we can use. For convenience, I have set up everything, Marathon, Mesos, Zookeeper, CI as a service application, everything on a single VM. So in order for the client to request for a CI, they need to use this REST service with the CI instance name what they would prefer. Let's say JUC demo. And they need to provide the different details, for instance, the app stack. So at eBay and PayPal, we use different technologies like Java, Node.js. Each different technologies needs different types of tools. So this abstract signifies what kind of tools the CI would need. And the requested by and the other information which are not of much significance. And this is a REST post request. Let me, before that, before triggering a request, let me show the Mesos. When you go to the Mesos URL, this is the web interface for the Mesos. You can see the active task. As Mani mentioned, Mesos cluster is managed by Mesos master and Mesos slaves. So this interface shows what are the different active tasks. And Marathon also shows the different applications. Each application will have different tasks. Application is basically a definition of a task, and we can have multiple instances of those instances running on different machines. You can have constraints on it. So as I mentioned, this is the Mesos web interface, and this is the Marathon. And this is the REST interface for request for a CI. And I provide the different information and submit a post request. So when you remember the diagram, it goes through the CI as a service, and it in turn requests Marathon for creation of the application. So this is the application which is created in order to create the CI instance. By default, we are creating one instance, one task, which invokes the CI instance, the Jenkins instance, and which in turn works with Mesos and creates the active task. This is the task you are seeing. It's part of the active task because it's running right now. When you look at it, sandbox is the place which shows the standard out and standard error, which comes out as part of running this command. So when you look at the standard out, it actually starts the Jenkins instance, loads all the plugins, loads different data it needs, and starts up the Jenkins instance. The user, after he's done with the post, he has submitted the CI request, he needs to check what the status of his request is. We use the same URL with the GET request. Now we submit. This shows that the CI provisioning is in progress, which means that it's still in progress. We need to check back on that. Meanwhile, you can see that the Jenkins instance is coming up. So now let's go back to the GET request and see what's the status is. You can see here the result is success, and the message says CI successfully provisioned. And it also provides a URL where I can go and access my CI instance. So from a user perspective, this is the URL he cares. And I have my CI instance. The other thing I want to demo is, once we have a CI instance, I need to run a job. We are using Mesos cluster even for procuring a slave and running a job. Let's first go and create a job. So I would say JUC demo job. So I'm just creating for a hello world job. So I would just do an echo. I would save it. Once we have the job, I will click on Build Now. So what it happens is, Jenkins scheduler will be talking to the Mesos cluster and invoking the getting the Mesos slave and base resource and invoking this particular job. So as you can see, it already has procured this Mesos slave. So this is the ID which it provides. It has run the command on that particular machine, and it's already done. When you go back to Mesos, as it was too fast, we are not able to see it. Oh, actually, we are able to see it. So this is the Mesos slave procured for Jenkins to use it as a slave. The job is already done. But Jenkins has actually not released the slave. If we run it subsequently, we will get the same slave, and we will have it. Done quickly. So after a while, it will give away the slave. So this is another use case. We use Mesos cluster. And as Mani mentioned earlier, it's also self-healing. Let's say if something goes bad. So let's say the Jenkins master goes down. So let's say, for some reason, this got killed. So I can kill the task from Marathon itself. Kill, it's lost. What Marathon does is, it restarts the server, the task on some other machine, whatever resource is available. So as you see, it started on another resource, but from the user perspective, as after like a couple of minutes, he still is. So this is actually still restarting the Jenkins server on the other machine. So it started on port 31884. So you can see the Jenkins master is up. As far as for a couple of minutes, we see the Jenkins master is down, but it's back up. So the user won't be worried just apart from this couple of minutes. And let's say if the user wants to get rid of this CI instance, because he's no longer using it. So we have a provided REST URL for delete. This will actually decommission the CI. So this will actually decommission the CI instance. Now you don't see any task for the Jenkins master. There is no application here. And even the instance is not up. This way, we can use the resources efficiently. Thank you.